Irrigation is a very important water use in the state of Oklahoma, and most of our irrigation water supply actually comes from groundwater. Groundwater, unlike surface water, is actually a private property right. In other words, if you own the land, you're allowed to extract that water out of an aquifer. And if you're going to do anything other than use that water for domestic use, as we talked about with surface water, you're going to have to file a permit with the Oklahoma Water Resources Board. Now, what is an aquifer? An aquifer is simply a geologic formation that contains water and transmits that water in usable quantities to wells and springs. And there's a couple of different types of aquifers that you're going to hear about. There's an unconfined aquifer, which is an aquifer that does not have an upper confining layer and typically is represented by the water level height is called the water table. There's also a confined aquifer, which has both upper and lower confining layers. And if you put a well in a confined aquifer, typically that water will rise up in that well because of the pressure that confined aquifer is at. Now, let's go back and talk a little bit about groundwater law. You're going to hear a little bit more about that in some future videos that we're going to do. But in terms of groundwater law, again, we said that this is a private property right. So how much water can you extract out of this aquifer? Well, in general, the OWRB will do hydrologic studies of each of the aquifer systems. And they'll typically set what is known as the maximum annual yield that can be extracted for each permitted user. Typically, that number is about 2 acre feet per year per acre of land that you own. If there's been a study and they have suggested that there is the maximum annual yield needs to be reduced, then that number may be reduced slightly. And a very good source of that information is to go on the OWRB website, and you can download a map that shows the location of all the aquifers within the state and their maximum annual yields. To extract water out of an aquifer, you're going to need to install a groundwater pump. And the OWRB, in order to get a permit, is going to require you to actually install that pump and have that pump installed from a licensed well driller. Now, when you pump water out of an aquifer, what that does create is it does create what is referred to as a cone of depression. It actually creates a cone where the water level will actually drop around your pumping well. A lot of people ask, well, how do I know if one pumping well might be, and the cone of depression might be influencing another pumping well? Well, that's really dependent on certain aquifer properties that may be specific to your site. And again, the researchers at Oklahoma State University, some of our state agencies such as the Oklahoma Water Resources Board would have information available for you and can calculate well interference between that. The couple of properties include the hydraulic conductivity of the aquifer and also a storage coefficient of the aquifer. Now, a lot of times we will actually pump water in the state out of alluvial aquifers. Alluvial aquifers are aquifers that are located next to a streams and they were laid down over time by the flow of the water. In many cases, those aquifers are unconfined. And when we pump water out of those unconfined aquifers, we may actually also be resulting in the depletion of some of that stream water. But right now, the state of Oklahoma does not consider the interaction between the groundwater and the surface water explicitly when they administer groundwater rights. So if you're going to pump out of an alluvial aquifer and you want to install a well, you're following basically the same principles as any other groundwater aquifer.